Hi, I'm Rebecca Short, Water Quantity Engineer with the Ontario Government. In this segment on maintaining a drip irrigation system, I'll show you how to flush irrigation lines, when to chlorinate, and what to watch for. The first task in drip irrigation system maintenance is to flush the lateral lines. This should be done at the start and end of each irrigation season. Flushing removes accumulated debris, reduces potential for emitter plugging, and allows for a diagnosis of any potential issues with the system. Flushing also removes air that may accumulate and become trapped. We first begin by flushing the lateral furthest from the pump and watch to see how much debris comes out. If the water runs dirty for 5 seconds or more, all the laterals should be flushed. Examine the debris to identify if it is bacterial buildup, chemical precipitate, or soil and sand. Bacterial buildup may be addressed by chlorinating. If it appears to be sand and soil, you may need to verify that the filtration is working adequately. If the lines are buried, it could also be a question of more air relief valves so that the drippers don't aspirate soil particles when the water supply is turned off and the system is draining. Next, examine the emitters to visually check for plugging. Use a drop of muriatic acid, also called hydrochloric acid, onto the scale or sludge. If it fizzes, that indicates it is calcium carbonate or magnesium carbonate precipitate. Significant buildup of these precipitates will eventually plug emitters. To remedy this, continuously inject acid to drop the pH to about 6.5. Emitter plugging can be monitored by measuring the flow rate for each zone and comparing it over time. A decreasing flow rate may be a sign of plugging. Inspect the emitters and the flushed debris to determine the cause. Next, check that the filtration system is operating correctly, as this may be the reason for the reduced flow rate. If using a sand filter, consider adding a screen filter after to catch any sand escaping. Fertilizer and other chemicals should be injected upstream of filtration. Bacteria and bacterial slimes can be killed by chlorination and then removed by flushing. Be sure to chlorinate the system at the beginning and end of the irrigation season. If you find that your water source is high in algae, consider chlorinating once a month during the irrigation season. Once the entire system is filled with chlorinated water, let it stand for 1 to 4 hours. A longer holding time is more effective. Finish up by flushing lateral lines after each chlorination. This will remove any dead organic material. For more information on drip irrigation systems, visit our website or give us a call.